I'm Corbett Wall with DV Auction, here with your feeder flash for Wednesday, February the 14th, Valentine's Day. Don't forget to send your sweetheart something nice. But this market going into this week is rocking right along here. Board was down a little bit on Tuesday, but not too bad. And even though we didn't have any clear market on your fat cattle trade last week, we had that after hours trade on Friday night there, it didn't seem to hiccup things any at all, and your feeder markets are rolling right along here, and even though it is terrible dry, and we our feedlots are full, and we've got a lot of cattle that's going to be coming up market ready here pretty soon, it seems like everything is staying the course right now. And you know, it might be a good time to sell some cattle if you've got them ready, because as you look down the pike, there's just not a whole lot more to be looking forward to other than a lot of really good demand for grazing type cattle. But it's so good right now, it makes you wonder how much better it could get. But you look at the board on Tuesday, April live cattle down 22 cents at 124.77. February is down 30 cents at 126.82. March feeder cattle down 40 cents at 147.27, and April down just 2 cents at 149.50. Your fat cattle trade, like I said, it's all I talked about there early in the week, was how they sold them after hours on Friday and kind of killed the market. We thought it was going to be 28, and they ended up getting enough cattle bought at 126, although we think they have a lot of captive supplies, formula cattle and things that they can get by on this week. They bought 66,000 in the five areas last week, which is not enough to completely fill their needs, so they'll have to use up some of that captive supply. But on Monday, probably a regional that didn't realize how many cattle it sold at 126, did have some cattle turned in on Monday from 128.5 to 129.5 live, and some 202 dress. So that would be higher if we could stick to that, but I think that's just kind of a carryover from the unknown that happened last week, and we'll have to establish another market this week. Box beef cutout values were a little lower on Tuesday. Choice cutouts 207.36 down 88 cents, and selects at 203.13 down 84. Feeder markets real-time index on Beef Market Central based on the 800-pound steer was up on Tuesday, up 59 cents from late Monday at 147.81, and just creeping right under that 150 mark there for 800-pound steer. And the starch is really kind of out of these feeder cattle. It's more on these grazing-type cattle, so it's good to see it holding up that well on feeding-type steers. Was at OKC West in El Reno, Oklahoma on Tuesday for the calf sale, and installing a new National Beef Wire market screen there, and they had a good run of calves there, about 3,500 head, and the market was on fire. You would have thought that it was wet around, and we were waiting for the warm weather to dry things out and for the green grass to come, but it is super dry. You know, all in this southwest part of the country, the southern plains, it's dry. Saw where the Amarillo area has not had any measurable moisture in 124 days. Had the wettest August in history of record keeping in Amarillo, and it hasn't rained a drop since. And no snow. Just nothing of anything to make something wet. But in OKC West at the calf sale on Tuesday, steer calves were $3 to $6 higher in this dry weather. Heifer calves were $4 to $8 higher. And people acting like, you know, the green grass is just going to appear someday, even though there's been no moisture to bring it on. But good market in Kingsville, Missouri at the Kingsville Livestock Auction. You look at their automated market report there on Cattle Market Central, mostly all higher on all your weight groups. But your most popular weight groups there was 6 and 7 weight steers. 426 head of 6 weight steers averaged 656 at 167.98. And 626 head of 7 weight steers averaged 754 at 146.82. Some individual quotes. Ozarks Regional Stockyards in West Plains, Missouri, 11 o'clock in the morning. And you might think this is not all that high. You hear of 5 weights bringing $2 and things. That's up in the Sand Hills in Nebraska. I'm talking about south central Missouri, Thor Rock to Arkansas. type deal in the rocks, in the Ozarks there. 80 head of 535-pound steers in West Plains bring 193. That's pretty respectable right there. Phillips, South Dakota had a big sale on Tuesday. They sold two loads of steers, weighed 786 pounds at $156.75. That's your feeder flash for Wednesday.